Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mangs, and I welcome you to part 3 of Let's Play Civilization 5, A Brave New World, playing as Napoleon of the French Empire. Alright, so we have currently settled our fifth city of Tours, and we are currently aiming to get universities in all of our cities, so we can catch up on our really poor science, which hasn't really been going that well. But hey, when you expand like crazy, you can't expect to have a lot of science. Now, we will finally get landed elites, and I'm really happy about that, because, well, Paris hasn't exactly been growing very steadily. I do believe we still have on... No, we have on default focus right now. We are working... I could actually grow Paris a little bit by forcing it to grow to work the tiles with 4 food. That might not be such a bad idea. But at the same time, I have 1 happiness, so maybe I shouldn't. Yeah, actually, I should perhaps look into getting some trades going. Yeah, my happiness could have been better. Let's see, yeah, I'm actually gonna grab a Colosseum, and in fact, I might chop a forest to make that happen. Same with here, I need to chop some forests in order to get this temple more quickly. Chopping down the forest is actually good, because if Alexander decides to attack Troyes, then he won't get the defensive cover of the forests. If, for example, he places ballistas here, then I can more easily shoot them down. Yeah. Alright, Ashurbanipal wants to buy incense. That's nice. That's 40 gold per turn that I'm currently getting, that I would not be otherwise getting, so I'm very happy about that. Milan is friendly with me. They want me to destroy a barbarian encampment. Ooh, well, that can be taken care of. Why didn't you just say so? Okay, Portugal stole a tech from me, those assholes. Well, guess there's nothing I can do about that right now. Okay, well, let's start working on the universities. We could actually move our pikemen right here. No, we need to promote them. They need to be in friendly territory. At any rate, let's bring our composite bowmen down here. Portuguese boy stole the secrets of masonry. That's fine. That's Maria. She's kind of just out of this game at this point. I don't see her being any threats. Ashurbanipal is about to be obliterated as well. Yeah. Orleans could potentially start working on a university, but my happiness is such a huge problem. I think I need to prioritize that a little bit right now. Do monasteries actually provide you with happiness? I do believe they do. Might as well. Or I could save up for some pagodas. I'm actually not quite sure. I'm gonna see. Let's see. Monasteries. Wait, yeah, Paris is naturally a city of. Let's see. No, actually not. So let's definitely go for pagodas instead of monasteries then. Promote. So we can get rid of that barbarian encampment. And let's just start working on tiles right here. I'm gonna cut this forest. As well as this forest right here. I should definitely get a stable in Tours, considering there's 2 sheep as well as a horse right here. Okay, Darius is wonder spamming like crazy. And now I'm in the negative, so I probably need to get some luxuries right now. Yeah, I might actually buy a luxury. We'll have to see. Let's go to diplomacy overview, shall we? Who has resources to sell? Harun has cotton. Yeah, I think I'm gonna buy cotton from Harun al-Rashid. It's gonna cost me 9 gold per turn. But that's worth it. You don't ever want to be dropping into the negatives. That production penalty is huge. Alright, let's go and get ourselves a barbarian encampment. Pikemen over there, good thing I upgraded my own. A university in Paris. I could theoretically save up for a university in Troyes. Wow, Troyes is actually 7 pop right now. That's impressive. Yeah, come to think of it, I think I should... do I want to work these tiles with hammers? It will give me the university quicker. He wants to buy copper. 8 gold per turn? Nah, even though he's friendly, he's not... Really? 6 gold then. Alright, I can settle for 6 gold per turn. I have so much copper, I'm pretty much selling copper to every single civ in the game right now, so... I have to make do with whatever deal they demand of me. Because I don't want to be sitting on an extra copy of copper that I can't do anything with, so... Alright. I could chop down forests, actually. Portugal is stealing a lot of shit from me right now. Not too sure about how happy I'm about that. I don't really care if they steal text, but still, it's annoying. Well, I'm getting some extra hammers. That's gonna help me with my temple, which will... Ooh, I should probably grab that silver right away before Alexander does. He's not gonna be happy about me buying area in his close to his city, but... If he didn't grab the silver, then I will. Alright, 17 turns until I'm gonna get my next policy. Now I have engineering. Ooh. Stupid pikemen. Embarking in front of archers. That's never a wise thing to do. Alright, let's grab that university by the tile with silver and improve that as quickly as possible so we can start selling silver. Ah, nice. We're buying pagodas. Now that we don't necessarily have a happiness problem anymore, I think I can set faith to auto-buy monasteries. Now, the reason why I want to buy the monasteries is because this religion is going to get wiped out pretty quickly, so I might as well grab the monasteries while I still can. You know, it can't hurt, so I'm going to chop this forest right here to speed up the Colosseum. And I also need another caravan. I should probably get working on that as soon as possible. Wow, Alec, Portugal is actually spreading their religion pretty aggressively. As long as they stay far away from my cities. I actually haven't checked my relations with them. I am not hostile with anyone yet. So I guess I haven't done anything major to piss people off as of late, which is a good idea. And I'm gonna get a golden age soon. In approximately 10 turns or so? Yeah, pretty much 9-10 turns. Alright, time to end this barbarian encampment once and for all, and that's gonna give me allied with Milan, which is gonna give me a whole buttload of culture. Now, I forgot to check what Maria thought of me. Alright, now Ur is this crazy religion that's just spreading everywhere. I'm not sure if I like that. I need to get my Grand Temple up quickly before Mosin Kani adopts a religion. They have begun getting pressure from other civilizations. Alright. Ah, there we go. Felt really, really good. Oh, barbarians! Okay, that's not good. We probably need to do something about that. Let's see, do we have any soldiers available? No, we don't. Can we buy any soldiers? No, we can't. Alright, we do have some composite bowmen right here, though. Okay, fine. That should make us allies with Milan. Really nice. And we might as well just start working on a farm right here. We're gonna need it eventually. 307 gold, 46 gold per turn. That's very nice. We're gonna finish our universities pretty soon. I might just buy a library in Tours. I don't think that city will get a library anytime soon, and I would like universities everywhere. After I'm done with iron working, so I can get workshops, I'm gonna go for astronomy, so I get those observatories. Ah, the barbarian is gonna pillage my tile. That's so annoying. But there's nothing I can do about that right now, other than being very annoyed. Alright, let's send these pikemen back to Orleans. Yeah, I can't really do much. I might as well just start building farms near Tours. That city is going to grow pretty quickly. I got to be careful about Harun al-Rashid, though. He might sneak attack me. I don't know what was up with that. My microphone bust out for some reason. Alright, a university soon. I'm going to place... I'm actually torn whether I should place specialists into the university right away. I might just attempt to grow my cities right now. Because I have suddenly have 18 happiness, so... I might just set my cities to food. That might actually be a good idea. Wow, those barbarians are really... Yeah, I'm gonna set my cities to food production right now. Let's see, there we go. So now my cities should be growing rather quickly. Let's grab a caravan, actually. 8 turns, but still. And let's grab a university in Orleans and a watermill in Tours. I could actually buy a library, and I think I will. Yeah, sounds like a good idea. Hey, stupid pikeman, stop. I think I need some more soldiers, to be quite honest. My military is rather laughable. If any of the leaders gets any stupid ideas to attack me right now, I am toast, and I'm pretty sure Alexander doesn't quite like me right now. I am actually tempted to build a fort right here. If he attacks me, though, it's most likely going to be from the south. But yeah, I need to grow my cities, and I need to grow my cities quick. So 20 happiness, you just need to grow, wow, down to 14. Okay, now, when I finish my... I'm not sure if I want to build aqueducts in my cities, to be quite honest. Maybe I should actually focus on... maybe I should focus on getting some barracks up. Or I could just build aqueducts. It's not... it's gonna take me a long time to actually... I'm only gonna get aqueducts in my first four cities anyway, so I might as well just build it in one of them. It's not like I have anything better to do with Leon at the moment. Alright, Darius keeps his wonder spamming. I really want to take his capital. Imagine all the juicy wonders in that thing. I can actually view his city, and I think I will. Alabama, Anchor Watt, Sitskin, it's a great library. Hagia Sophia, Hangin Gardens, National College, Notre Dame, and Terracotta Army. This guy has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 wonders. Wow. This guy. And he... and now he's building a university. Alright. Well, I can still attack. Very good. Let's see. Guilds is probably the one I want to go for. Although I really need to get sailing now, so I won't get the option to steal stupid shit like that. Alright, let's grab accuracy. Let's go repair these tiles, actually. We really need to go repair these tiles. Ah, we have the worker here. Never mind. Let's see. Yes, awesome. Now we have a level 2 spy, which means we'll steal another tech in 8 turns. I hope Darius didn't find out about it. Ah, crap. Okay, I swear not to spy on you anymore. Now I have to move it, or else I'm going to get a huge, massive penalty. Alright, we'll move it to Rome then. You don't ever want to break your word. That's too big of a penalty. I mean, he already dislikes me a little now because I stole his shit. But if I say I'm not going to spy and then don't move away, then I'm going to get a massive, massive penalty. That's not good. I think I might hard buy a workshop in Orleans. Because that city has some serious production problems. Okay. Tours is coming along pretty nicely, and now I have another caravan. Let's see how much gold I can get for that. Let's just first, let's see if we have any quests. We don't. Actually, we do. Ragusa. That is tempting. But at the same time, 12 gold per turn. That is even more tempting. Yeah. I'm sorry. And it will also spread our religion, which is even more tempting. Now we want marble. That's interesting. What could we possibly get with marble? Or how could we possibly get marble, I should rather say. Anyone has marble? Well, Darius has one marble. Not looking so good with marble, unless we get it from a city-state of some kind. At least now we have access to workshops, so we should probably get those in all of our cities, so we can get ironworks in Paris. Mm-hmm. 19 turns. That's a very long time to build a university, I gotta say. Alright, I just gotta check something really quick. Alright, there we go. I just had to check some recording stuff to see if my microphone was plugged in correctly. That is always a big scare of mine. like sitting for like 30 minutes talking and then realize my microphone isn't attached to the computer. It has happened before, and it is very, very annoying when it happens. Alright, he wants to buy copper. Why does he propose 5 gold per turn when he knows I want 7? Oh, I can get another caravan. Probably a good idea. Probably a good idea. Ooh, I don't like these pikemen. He's not planning to attack me, is he? Surely he can't be planning to attack me. That wouldn't be very nice. I don't want to go to war with Pocatello. It's been too long since I bribed someone to declare war. Let's see if I can get Pocatello. He is neutral at the moment. Does he covet my lands? No, he doesn't. Maybe you want to declare war on Harun? Nah. How about declare war on Assyria? No. He is a pretty peaceful dude. It's pretty difficult to get him to declare war on anyone, really. Alright, Paris is growing pretty quickly right now. On food focus, it's growing, it's working all those 4 food tiles, which is really helping. I might even get an aqueduct in the city. Although I will... It is tempting to not get aqueducts, considering I'm working on finishing my tradition tree. But if I am grabbing an aqueduct in Lyon, so if I then finish my tradition tree, then I will get 4 free aqueducts, which will cover the rest of my cities. Which sounds like a good plan, in my opinion. Oh, Augustus Caesar is plotting against Maria, you say? That's fine. Let's share the intrigue. This bitch is really hard to please. She is usually always pissed about something. I really don't like Maria. She's a very difficult leader to negotiate with. Alright, he wants silver. Zero gold? Seriously, Augustus? You have 0 gold per turn? I am actually a little bit... alright. He's really getting his ass kicked by Athens, isn't he? I do believe they're still at war. How is he doing on demographics? Persia is... Nah, actually, Harun al-Rashid is the worst right now. I am number 5. So that's good. I'm almost dead last on population, though. That's how bad I'm doing. Which is really pitiful. Alright. Don't really think I need that many more. I could chop some more wood, I suppose. Okay, Paris. What does Paris need? Workshops, definitely. Let's see. Do we want to trade with city-states to get influence? I'm not allied with... Okay, I'm going to trade with Ragusa right now. That's only 5 gold per turn, but it will give me some influence. Let's see. I should probably bribe them. Do I have any quests with them? No, I don't. Alright, let's grab those workshops. And also, let's grab monarchy. Or do I want aristocracy? No, actually. I probably want monarchy, and that's going to give me a lot of gold. So 2 more tenants until I can finish the tradition opener. No, Persia, I don't want you to move through my borders. I actually haven't checked culture or see if any one of them are actually working on tourism. Check Persia. Persia has some tourism. Not much, but some. I gotta be careful. Harun al-Rashid might get some funny ideas. This would be a very easy target for him if he wanted to attack a city. So I'm a little bit perplexed as to why he hasn't done it yet. Maybe he just loves me that much. You never know. I am quite a popular guy. Nice guy, Napoleon. Alright, desert tiles, I'm not really interested in working those, though a mine would perhaps be nice. Am I working the mine right now? Oh, you want to buy copper, do you? How many only 4 gold per turn? That's not a lot. So maybe I could actually take a loan from her and then give her more income so she could give me more income? No, that won't work unless we have a declaration of friendship together. Alright. See. 14 more turns. We should probably chop some wood so we can get that university up quicker. Now, I think the longer you are away from the capital, the less production you receive from the forest you chop. But I could chop this forest as well. What do you want? Alright. Yeah, grab a farm. Okay, Troyes has completed its university. Then we can start on a workshop. Another monastery has been purchased. I do believe that's the last monastery we'll get. So now we can swap over to Pagodos. I'm pretty sure I can't get any more. Well, we'll chop this forest right here. Should help a little bit. Yeah, 10 production. That's alright. That's about a turn worth of production. Better than constructing improvements we're not going to be using at any rate, so... We could even chop this forest right here. I don't see why we shouldn't. I can chop this forest right here. Yeah. Chop all the forests. It says it wants me to produce a farm right here, but it's not really going to use it for anything, so I don't really understand why. But that's the computer for you. Doing stupid things like always. Never listen to the computer. Yeah, the watermill is coming along quite nicely. Now we have compass in 11 turns. Yeah, and you need new automatic fate selection. It is to be expected. We can now grab the pagodas. Really? Oh. We have a pagoda here. Do we? Do we have a pagoda? Yes, we do. Alright, guess we'll just remind me later then. I am tempted to grab the Grand Temple. Wow, 31 turns. Holy crap. That's not gonna happen yet. Not until I get the ironworks. That's for sure. Yeah, I guess we'll just chop some more forests. Give me a great profit then, I suppose. Yeah, I'm gonna chop this forest as well. 320 gold. Maybe I can buy a university? That probably wouldn't be a bad idea. Or I could buy some caravans, actually. That probably would be a good idea. I can suddenly have a lot of trade routes now. I should really utilize them. They give a lot of gold. Or maybe I should bribe Ur. No, Alexander. I do not want to open borders with you. If I bribe them... That's gonna be a lot of food for me. So I need... to become allies with them. Alright, let's bribe them then. Alright, that's gonna give me allies with them for 14 turns. I think that's a pretty good deal. Alright, let's chop this forest as well. What, didn't we chop this one already? Oh, okay. Never mind then. I was... planning on speeding this university up, but I guess not. See, I don't think I'll place any specialists into the university. I don't really have the food for it. I need to grow Paris bigger. No, thank you. I don't really want your truffles, but I want your gold. See, how much is it for a caravan? 390 gold. Yeah. That's not gonna happen yet. I guess I could just hard build one after I've done building a workshop. Choppy choppy. So when are we gonna get our next policy in 15 turns? That's not gonna happen yet. I do believe it's gonna be smooth sailing until I get musketeers, and that's when I'm gonna start getting aggressive. This capital is so ripe for the taking. I mean, literally, I see no good reason not to take this capital. Except for that the other cities are going to start. I'm actually even tempted to start building a road towards it. That's how secure, that's how safe I feel about taking it. Yeah, I think I'm actually going to start building a road towards Lipson. All the way over here. That's going to make my invasion a lot easier. Alright, let's... What, really? I was gonna chop this forest, man. What are you doing? Is he trying to protect his forests? That might be what is exactly what he's doing. Alright, so do I want the workshop or the university first? I think I'm gonna go for the workshop, to be quite honest, because I do need the production. And then I could perhaps hard buy the university? I don't know. Depends on what I want to do with my gold. But I do want workshops in all my cities, so I can get ironworks in Paris, which will give me a shit ton of production. Alright. Let's see. But I need to work on those caravans soon. Malacca seeks a natural wonder. Is my scout still exploring? Yes, it is, actually. Huh. Wow, that's interesting. Okay. I'm gonna chop this forest. Oh, he's building a lumber mill. Alright, then. Let's build a mine. Now we can chop this forest as well. I don't like trees. You have a lot of workers, you might as well put them to do something useful instead of just standing around. Chopping forest isn't doing much, but it is something that they can do. Alright, 6 turns and then I need to get started on observatories. I need to get what I want within that. I think I'm gonna start building caravans in Lyon and sending them to Paris and starting trade routes. Sounds like a plan. I can't get pagodas yet. I need a great prophet to spread my religion around. In fact, a great prophet is exactly what I need. So I can get rid of all these other lesser religions. I don't have temples in all my city yet? Right, tours, of course. I completely forgot about tours. Just a second, just had to adjust my headset a little bit. Alright, choppy choppy. Let's get... Oh, I can actually get a farm here because it's next to freshwater. I didn't think about that. Yes, definitely caravan. Can we even speed it up? 3 turns. Yeah, I think I'm actually going to do that. Yeah, sounds like a good idea. We could check if the other AIs have any luxury resources we need. That sounds like a good plan. Also, we're working on this road. Don't worry, don't worry. We're just building a road to your capital. You know, just helping out. Working on our friendship and stuff. It has nothing to do with you, Maria. I just like building roads everywhere. I swear, I'm not going to use it for an invasion. Alright, we're generating 104 science right now. We could get even more if I place specialists inside the universities, but right now I'm struggling a little bit with the size of my cities. It's improving, though. It is improving pretty rapidly. Let's see, do we need more improvements right now? No, we don't. Absolutely not. So we can keep chopping forests to our heart's content. I think I'm gonna chop this one, this one, this one, all the forests, really. Chop them away. I'm like Saruman. I'm gonna make an army of Urukai. I think I have reinforced my religion, so that's good. But until I get that great prophet, my religion is not really gonna do much. But I have monasteries, though, in my cities, which is nice. They give me 2 faith and 2 culture. And the temples, too, give me culture. Actually, this one won't, because that's not part of my religion yet. That kind of sucks, actually. Alright, let's go chop down that forest. Now what are we going to do in Paris? I am thinking... I had a plan for Paris. Yeah, probably just going to go for a caravan. That sounds like the most solid idea to do right now. You got to get caravans immediately. You can't postpone caravans. They are too important for your economy. If you neglect caravans, you're not going to get any gold. Oh, and gold is power. Like, without an economy, you can't do shit. Ooh, the wheat tile is available. I'm going to go get that immediately once I'm done with this road. I think I'm already working it. No, not yet. But I will soon, once I improve it. That tile will be worth 4 food and 1 hammer. Which is nice. I would be very suspicious if I saw someone building a road to my capital. Very. Alright, caravan completes. I'll send that to Paris, turn the city over to food production again. To make it grow. Oh, 5 happiness right now. Where in the fuck did that happen? Alright, let's grab a circus then. We're done with the... maybe you should grab walls and tries? Okay, market first. And choppy choppy. Let's see. What kind of resources do we need to enter Wheel of the King Day? Crab, sugar, marble, salt. Crab, sugar, marble, salt. Let's talk to each of the different leaders, see what they have for us. You have whales, I'm not interested in that. You have marble, but only one. Caesar has nothing. Harun al-Rashid has nothing. Pucatello has nothing. Ashurbanipal has nothing. I have 12 horses, though. There must be someone who values horses on this map. Alexander, for example, has nothing, but he has a lot of gold. He doesn't value horses. How about Pucatello? Do you value horses? He values horses. Do you want 25 gold per turn for that? 20? 15? Maybe he doesn't want as many horses. Alright, well, I'm gonna give you some of my horses then. 5 gold per turn? Sounds like a good deal. Anyone else value horses? You don't have shits. But Darius, you want horses? Yes, he wants horses. There we go. 10 extra gold per turn. You should always sell your strategic resources whenever you can. There's no reason to sit on horses if you're not planning on building horse units. That is just a waste of horses and a waste of money, in my opinion. Okay, let's see. University in 3 turns, that's nice. We might have enough gold to actually start building a... How much is it for a workshop? 580 gold. Well, once these two caravans kicks in, then we should have enough money to buy a workshop, which will give us ironwork in Paris. Sounds like a good idea. Alright, you want me to build a farm there, why on earth would I do that? I'd much rather come and chop forests. Yeah, I'm gonna go chop forests. Chop forests, okay. Do we have any trading quests? Let's see, no trading quests. Alright, then we'll just go for the highest gold, which happens to be Athens right now. So now we're getting 62 gold per turn, and boom, observatories, which we need to get right now. After I'm done with the circus, of course. That's going to be so much science, holy crap. Should I finish this market? Probably. Probably would be a good idea. Oh, a great prophet. What does he want? Not sure if I'm really too keen on that. Yeah, that's right. I was saving up my faith for a great prophet. I'm getting 27 faith per turn, which is quite ridiculous, actually. That is a lot of faith. I haven't really started generating any great persons. Now, you don't have to rush the artist guilds. If you build them later, you will catch up pretty darn quickly. Alright, we're in the Renaissance right now, which is good. This is kind of where the French Empire shines. Because we're now, right now, I think I'm going to go for gunpowder. Chivalry first, so I can get chateaus, and then gunpowder. And that means musketeers, and we all know what that means. That means war. Glorious, epic war. So I'm probably just going to build barracks on all my city and churn out a whole bunch of musketeers. And that's going to be fun. I think I can take Lisbon with just musketeers. That city has like 21 defense strength. What the hell? And she has so many whales. That's gonna be in this city is gonna be so insanely good once I capture it. It's a wonder none of the other AIs have actually conquered her. What's going on over here by Rome? Stealing a technology in 7 turns. Not necessarily sure if Rome has that much more tech than me. It's a pretty big city, but I'm actually not that sure. Could be that Persia is the one I need to go for. But I don't want to damage my diplomatic relations with him even further. All right, finally we have a university done. I think I need to go for a workshop before I can build the observatory. That's just too long right there. All right, fine. I'll build a bloody farm then. Don't have any more forest to chop down, so I might as well. 600 gold. No, definitely we're gonna fuck that shit. We're gonna build the workshops. We're gonna buy it. Or I could buy it in Troyes. I already have it in Troyes. Alright then. No, I don't. Did I build a workshop in Troyes already? I can't remember doing that. I gotta check. So I have 3 allied city-states at the moment, which is really good. Oh, wait. Yeah, 1, 2... What? Only... No, 1, 2, 3. No, 1, 2. Alright, I'm not allied with Milan. Alright. Did I really get a workshop in Troyes? Yes, I did. I might spend my money elsewhere then. In fact, I might just spend it on a university. Yeah, I think that's a much better choice, actually. Because that means I can get Oxford University if I want to. However, I think an observatory... Actually, a stable first, because I have one... Wait a minute. Only one? Yeah, that's not going to give me that much. No, I think I'm... Yeah, I'm going to grab the observatory first, actually. And we have our 4th caravan, which is going to Lisbon, unless I've suddenly got some quests. No, I didn't. Oh, Lisbon. I'm going to capture that city soon. I think I'd rather trade with Harun al-Rashid. Even though it's worth slightly less in terms of gold. So 61 gold per turn now. That's pretty good. Yes, marble. Actually, that's exactly the resource I wanted. How did you know that? I know one of my cities demand marble, so that's a really good trade in my eyes, even though it doesn't give me any gold. And what is that great prophet doing in my territory? You're not planning on spreading your filthy religion to me, are you, Alexander? Oh, he's the one with this stupid religion. I should have known. How is Mohsen Khan? He still doesn't have a religion. He's getting pressured from all sides, though. Not sure if I can necessarily get my religion to him in time. I need to use my own great prophet to actually spread my religion to my own cities, by the looks of it. Alright, we finally have chivalry, and 2 cities loves the king. That's nice. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, I think I'm going to end this part right here. We're getting to chivalry, and we're getting to gunpowder pretty... Actually, we're almost there. In about 10-18 turns, we will be starting to build musketeers, which we will use to take Lisbon, crush Lisbon, in fact, and take it, and then maybe go to war with Alexander? That sounds like something that'd be fun. I mean, there's going to be wars in this game. I trust me, there will be wars. So, yeah. Alright, well, I'll see you later, ladies and gentlemen. Hope you guys enjoyed this part. As always, my name is Imangs, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye!